the parents came home from church, all their children were gone. They searched and called for them, they cried and begged, but it was all to no avail. The children have never been seen again. I have to get out of here and find out what this ticket is about. Gonna have to make it through the crowd. I can't take crowds. Just can't handle it. I can't make it. Too many people. Too many people.
Dad. Jason!
Line 18, box number 3.
Sean.
Where are you? I'm so cold. Dad. Dad.
The killer is white, aged between 30 and 45. He doesn't act on impulse, but plans his crimes in a very meticulous fashion. He doesn't have anything personal against the victims. That's why he covers their faces with mud, to make them anonymous.
Why does he kill them if he doesn't have anything against them?
For him, they're more of an image, a symbol. That's probably why he gives them an origami figure and an orchid as gifts to apologize for what he's done to them.
Very interesting. And where does all that get us?
The best way of tracking a predator is to be familiar with his behavior.
That may be true in novels, but there's a child's life at stake here.
Continue, Jaden.
One detail attracted my attention. The interval between the time when a victim disappears and the time when the body is found ranges from 3 to 5 days. But the rainfall is always at 6 inches, give or take 10%.
What on earth does that mean?
All the victims were drowned in rainwater. The killer kills only in the fall when there is plenty of rain. It could be that he puts them in some sort of well or tank that is open to the skies and that fills up with rainwater. The more it rains, the less time the victim has to live. Then I studied the geographical distribution of the murders. Generally, a killer commits his first murder near to where he lives, so he has a safe place to flee to if any complications arise. The more confident he becomes, the further he roams from his base. By analyzing the locations where the victims disappeared, I was able to isolate a zone where the killer might live.
And what size is this, zone?
For the moment, about 10 square miles.
Oh, great. There must be 10,000 people live in that sort of area. You gonna question them one by one?
The more clues we get, the more we can reduce the zone. We can then cross-check it with our list of suspects and identify the killer.
So what's next?
There are two suspects whose psychological profile might fit and can be connected to the comfort zone. I'd like to question them.
God damn it. We're wasting our time with this bullshit. The killer's out there somewhere, and we gotta get off our asses and find him.
The killer is no ordinary murderer. He is intelligent, organized, and methodical. You won't find him by patrolling the streets.
Tell me, Agent Jaden, did you get your vast experience on the job, or did you just fucking read about it in some school book?
I came here to find a killer. And that is exactly what I'm gonna do. With or without your
fucking
help.
Fucking asshole!
That's enough!
You said it took 6 inches of rainfall before the victim died. How much time do we have left?
If the weather forecasts are right, less than 72 hours. No answer. We waste our time coming here.
Maybe we should have a little look inside anyway.
There's nobody home.
There is now.
I'm not sure that's entirely legal.
Call the cops.
Looks like Nathaniel Williams is a pretty religious guy.
He's a God-fearing idiot, waiting for the end of the world. We questioned him a few months back because he was causing a disturbance in the park. He was ranting and raving. Said he heard voices. Had this idea in his sick little head that I was the Antichrist, that I'd come to Earth to persecute him. Real twisted. Good timing, Nathaniel. Just the man we're looking for.
Angels and ministers of grace defend us. I'm Agent Naaman Jaden, FBI. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
As God is my witness, I haven't done anything. I'm innocent.
Relax. Nobody's accusing you of anything. We just want to talk. Nathaniel, do you remember where you were last Tuesday at 4:30 p.m.?
Here? I was here. I was praying. All day.
Was there anybody with you?
No. No, I was alone.
Why all the crucifixes? You afraid of something?
The hour is nigh, and the wrath of God shall strike men down. I'm preparing for the end of the world.
Where do you work, Nathaniel? You have a job?
My sole occupation is praying to the all-merciful Lord for the salvation of humanity.
What about the voices, Nathaniel? Do you still hear the voices? We know who talks to you, don't we, Nathaniel? Or we both know who talks to you.
Don't speak that name.
What does he say to you, Nathaniel?
I can't talk about it. You mustn't talk about it.
He orders you to go and find new prey, doesn't he? He needs more and more.
No. No. You mustn't mention him. You'll bring him here.
He told you to go and find that kid in the park. The voices tormented you all night long. You wanted them to stop, didn't you, Nathaniel?
Stop. Stop. That's enough.
So you obeyed them to make them stop. You took that boy with you and you drowned him. Isn't that right?
Oh. No. Stop. Stop.
You killed them, didn't you, Nathaniel? Are you gonna confess, you bastard?
You are the Antichrist.
Put down the gun, Nathaniel.
I shall dispatch you to your father in hell. He is the son of Satan. He was sent to earth to destroy us. For Christ's sake, shoot!
Calm down, Nathaniel. Nobody here wants to hurt you. Put the gun down. Keep calm. Everything is gonna be fine, Nathaniel.
Demon, you shall regret confronting the emissary of the Lord. You shall know divine power.
I shot him.
Yep. Looks like you did. Can't say I'll miss him. Come on, let's go.
No answer. Baby screaming inside. Not a promising start. Anybody home? This is Bowles. Hello, little cutie. Oh, you looking for your mama? Oh, Jesus. Wait a minute. Mrs. Bowles? Mrs. Bowles, are you there? Mrs. Bowles! Mrs. Bowles, can you hear me? Wake up! Wake up! I'm gonna call an ambulance.
No, I don't want to go to the hospital. Please.
Okay. You got something around here I can dress this wound with?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, don't move. I'll be right back. Let's see. I need this, and this, and this. I'm here for you, Susan. You'll be all right. I'll take care of you. There, I done what I can. That should stop the bleeding. Well, luckily, the wounds aren't too deep. Hey, how are you feeling? Okay?
My baby. My baby needs me.
Right. You stay there. I'll take care of the baby. Okay?
Do you know what to do? With a baby, I mean.
I'm a private eye. There's nothing I can't do.
Her name is Emily.
Gotcha. Hi there, Emily. So, what seems to be the problem, huh?
Oh! Going by the smell,
I got a pretty good idea.
Hey, Okay. How do you do this again? There you go, fresh new baby. That should feel better. Right, Emily? Hey, what's the matter? I thought we solved the problem. I guess I better warm this thing up. Emily, are you hungry? Huh? You hold on. I'll just tilt this bottle a little bit so you don't choke. Okay. Oh, good job, Emily. You're feeling good now, right? Now, I'm gonna rock you very gently so you can have a nice little snooze.
Thanks for looking after my baby. I didn't want to leave her. I just couldn't cope anymore. Just not having Jeremy around. He was such a good boy. Can't understand why anyone would want to hurt him.
Do you take care of this baby on your own? Doesn't Jeremy's father live with you anymore?
He disappeared. The day after Jeremy. I don't know what happened to him. Maybe he couldn't take it. Ever since I've had to look after Emily all on my own and I couldn't do it anymore.
I understand. Did your husband say anything before he disappeared? Did he leave a note or something?
No. He left the house without a word and there was just a cell phone.
A cell phone?
Yeah, I found a cell phone in his dresser. I'm sure it wasn't his. I'd never seen it before. I tried to turn it on, but it didn't work.
Do you still have it?
Yeah, it's It's in a drawer in the living room. You can have it if you'd like. I'm sure it's of more use to you than to me.
Do you have any family or anybody to help you?
Yeah. My mother. I didn't want to ask her for anything. We don't really get along. But I guess I'm out of